Hi everyone, this is Paul Ricard. I'm a principal at Oliver Wyman. We're here at InsureTech Connect 2018 in Vegas at the MGM Grand. I'm here with Rick McCathron from Hippo. He's the head of insurance. Hi Rick.
Welcome.
Thank you for having me.
So why don't we start with you telling us a little bit about what Hippo is.
Well, Hippo is a modern, simpler homeowners insurance program. We're live in 12 states. We'll be live in 15 states by the end of the year, hoping to expand nationally next year.
All right. So what makes Hippo different in the homeowners insurance market?
Great question. Well, really three different things. First is the customer experience. So what we've recognized, at the end of the day, customers want to make sure that they have a simple sign-up process. So our customer experience is very quick. You can get an online quote in less than 60 seconds. You can buy a policy in less than 4 minutes. The second aspect of that is our use of data. So we ask all the traditional insurance company questions, but we don't ask them to the policyholder or to the prospective customer. We ask them of data sources. So if you're getting ready to move into a house and somebody asks you, how old is that roof? You have no idea because you've never lived in that house before. So we go out and get various data elements answered to reduce friction of the question and then get better underwriting results because it's verifiable third-party data. That's the first thing. Second thing is we've modernized the policy itself. So we recognize that most homeowners insurance policies were written in the 1960s. They cover you for things like fur coats and pewter bowls, gold bullion and stock certificates, crypts and mausoleums, things that may have been important to our parents and grandparents, but maybe less important to the modern consumer today. So we've enhanced and modernized the coverage. Make sure you have ample coverage for home office. 1 out of 5 Americans works from home. We want to make sure you have plenty of coverage for that. Electronic equipment. More than just the standard $1,500 or $2,000, I have more than that in my backpack at any given time. Then the third thing is a proactive approach, making sure that we have an ongoing relationship with you, the customer, making sure that we're monitoring your house, your life, your exposure as time goes on.
What are some things you guys have in the works or have just been going in the past few weeks or months?
Yeah, we're very excited. We have strategic partnerships with Comcast, with Notion. We're now providing policyholders smart connected home devices to help mitigate risk and mitigate exposure to them. We're really excited about our state expansion. We really want to focus on the homeowners insurance space and the different flavors of insurance related to that. So your traditional home insurance, condo, townhouses, rental properties, new construction properties, those types of things. So singularly focused on geographical expansion, really making Hippo that national brand to bring modern homeowners insurance to as many people as we can.
What are some of the big challenges that you are anticipating as you guys are growing, and how are you planning to address them?
Yeah, it's the interesting thing about insurance, and I've been in this industry for 25 years, it's a heavily regulated industry. So the biggest challenge we have is to help all stakeholders recognize the transition and the renaissance that is InsureTech. So making sure people understand that what may have made sense years ago may not make sense now. We have a very embracive attitude. We generally believe there are win-wins in every scenario, and that includes the regulator. So we want to work with the regulators. We want to play in the NAIC sandbox and come up with ways that we can say collectively what's in the best interest of their constituents, our customers, and the greater good of all.
And what are some of the interesting things you've observed and experienced as you shifted from a traditional insurance carrier life to the startup life?
Yeah, so yes, I'm a traditionalist. I'm a chartered property and casualty underwriter and a certified insurance counselor. Been doing this for 25 years. A couple of things. One, the obvious, I'm wearing a t-shirt, right? Which is very different than what you'll generally see in the insurance industry. Secondly, just an embracive, collaborative atmosphere. Our offices are wide open spaces. We have no individual offices. Our CEO sits on the floor with our underwriters and our support people and our call center people on a daily basis. That collaborative environment where the underwriter and the engineer are sitting next to each other, they can collaborate and come up with new ideas. We don't schedule conference calls. We lean over and talk to our partners and our colleagues on how we can improve and how we can enhance things.
What are some things that you've seen that have impressed you, or that have sparked your mind over the past couple of days here at ITC?
Yeah, I think the great thing about ITC is the cross-section of people we have at this event. It's becoming the sort of the preeminent event within the insurance industry. You have technologists, you have underwriters, you have carriers, you have reinsurance companies, you have vendors, you have claims companies, you have media and press, and everybody that's recognizing that the insurance industry is massive. It makes up a tremendous amount of our economy, and how can we all get here and collaborate together? And as a person that's been in the industry for a long time, what impresses me is all of the sort of incumbent industry people that get excited about change, that embrace the change, and are really looking for ways to improve the experience, both within their organization or with the consumer at large.
Well, Rick, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you. I
really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Once again, we're here at the MGM Grand in Vegas for ITC 2018. Hopefully, we will all see you next year at next year's event. Thank you.